Hi guys, welcome to WebZeta. So in this one I'm going to talk about very basics of Svelte. If you haven't watched my previous video on why I like Svelte, I recommend you go watch it. You might get a lot of insights on why one should use Svelte, how it is different than other frameworks, and how it might help you build better websites. I'm going to jump right in to the basics of Svelte. I'm going to go to REPL and you can try out Svelte here. If you are a beginner, I recommend not to install it in your system and maybe try it here. And if you like it, only then maybe you can try building something on your system. And for learning as well, you know, this is very useful. I'm gonna make this full screen and I'm gonna make it a little bigger. I think that's too much. Okay, this should be enough. All right. Now, I'll start with something very basic. I'll remove everything here. I would like to start with a blank canvas. Now, I'll have a tag, a simple paragraph tag, which says, maybe Svelte is awesome. Okay, so that comes there. This is cool. I mean, even HTML file does it. Now, I can make it dynamic having a script. So we'll make we'll make something like, you know, the message what we have here or text what we have here comes from somewhere. That's all. So we'll have a variable, let message equals, this is a string. I'll just cut this here and put it there. And if I want that string here, I just name it. I just call it inside these curly braces and we got it. And now this is kind of dynamic. Now, doing this in plain JavaScript itself is hard. Even on jQuery, it's kind of tricky. It's easier than plain JavaScript, but it's tricky. Svelte makes it way easier. I haven't seen any other framework making it this easy. And this is not it. We can try some functions on it. Like, let's say you have a message and you want to check how many characters it has, or even including spaces. You can just try the length and you get 17. So there are 17 characters including spaces. This is a very nice thing that, you know, you can just use these dot operators that we have in JavaScript. This is a string operator. If I want, let's say, index of w, so there is only one w and I want to know where that w is, I can just have index of w and it's at the 11th place. I can have index of ease, where is ease? It's at 7. I can have index of awesome, so it's at the 10th place. From here, of course, this is 0, and then this is like 10. A is at 10. Now, I can do this. I can also do a few other things, like, you know, maybe it's shown in the tutorial as well, in Svelte tutorial. So you can do two upper case and it becomes uppercase. And I can use something like replace. Okay, so if I want to replace something in this string, let's say I want to replace awesome to amazing, that happens right away. You may get the feel of having control over the things here. You can change pretty much everything. You can also have math operators here. So let's say let's say you have some money with you, and then that's somewhere like million. I don't know if that is million, but anyway, I hope so. So you can just show your money here. Okay, I'll show it in a different tag, something like free maybe, or even code. That's okay. Yeah, we have a million. You can use operators on it. So if you're using this million and you don't, you know, you want to make it readable, you can also use underscores and it doesn't change anything. You'll still have the same thing here. Let's say you want to divide it by 100. You can do that right there. You want to add some 90 or something, you can do that right away. So whatever you define in these curly braces, you can also use math operators. That's something something good. The next thing we are going to do is nested components. Nested in the sense, you know, you can have different components, one inside the other, or you can separate things. So let's say you want the message to be somewhere in a component and the money to be somewhere in another component. So I'll just have this as a p tag. I'll let you know why I'm doing this. So we have both message and money. So let's imagine I move the message to one component and money to another. Okay, so I'll copy this message to here, copy the money to this component, and even the script, we need it on message. We only need message there, we don't need money. And here we only need money, not the message. Okay, so these are we'll make a separation of script and HTML. Okay, so these are two components, and there is, you know, we don't need it here. So there is nothing there. We will have to import these components. So first thing, I'll import the message from message.svelte. Okay, so now that I have imported it, I can use it, and it should come there. So there is, okay, import is not defined. Okay, from, I missed from. You have to import it from this file. Anyway, so that's message. And then I'll import money the same way. Okay, and you have it. So these two components, now they are components, are paragraphs. Basically, they're just paragraphs, right? So let's say I style, you can have a style tag here itself. Style the paragraph on message to something like maybe font weight to be bold, right? So now it is bold. And I use something similar on money, maybe color to no, color is just color green. It applies to the particular component, though they are both paragraphs. They are scoped, only apply to their own component, doesn't flow to the other, you know, other component. Even though it's, this is also a paragraph tag, it's not bold because there is no cascading happening here. So this avoids a lot of problems with CSS. This is something I really like about Svelte. And finally, let's say, you know, you have string has some HTML tag in it. So let's say you have a list item. It's fast. Something like this. And also you have another list item. It is easy. Okay, I'll make this capital. So you don't want it to be shown like this. I mean, you want it to be in HTML. What you can do is you can just have add HTML and it will render the whole thing. That's awesome, right? Even if you have it in strings, you can render that using add HTML. So that covers the very basic of Svelte on how to use it. I'm hoping you understood what's happening here. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. It was very basic. I mean, there was nothing in it. But I'll be coming up with a lot of videos which are gonna be fantastic. All right, guys. Thanks. Bye.